Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to invite multiple users to Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. Most accounting software programs allow you to give other users access. This is helpful since you can give employees user accounts as well as an outside CPA and control what each individual has access to. Generally, the more folks you give access to, the more you have to pay. However, Xero offers something that its closest competitors do not. You can give an unlimited number of users access to your account without incurring any additional cost. Once you have granted a user access to Xero, they will be able to log in from their office without having to bother you. In this lesson, we will discuss the user roles available, the ideal user for each role, and how to send them an email invitation to access your data. So let's go ahead and go into Xero by clicking on the Settings option and selecting General Settings. Right below the Organization section, we can go ahead and click on Users. And as you can see, we have a few users already set up, and so we'll go ahead and click on Invite a User to set up a new user. So there are four primary sections in this screen. We've got our first section, which is the New User Details, where you want to enter the first and last name of the new user and their email address. The second section is the access to accounts or key tasks that we can actually give access to. So those are going across here. The third section is actually the user roles. So we've got five listed here. And then the last section is this section down here where it's additional permissions. So let's start with our key tasks or areas of access. So starting with bank reconciliation, this level of access allows the user to add, modify, or delete banking transactions as well as reconcile bank accounts. The standard and advisor roles are the only two users that have bank reconciliation access. So as you can see in this column, the other three users have X's, and we've got standard and advisor where we can actually give access to bank reconciliations here. You also notice in the dropdown where it says non-cash coding and cash coding here. You can learn more about cash coding by checking out the How to Reconcile Downloaded Banking Transactions lesson. Click here to access this lesson. All right, next column here, invoices. This level of access allows the user to add, modify, and delete customer invoices and supplier bills. It also allows access to view sales and purchase reports, as well as print or email invoices. Standard, advisor, and invoice-only roles have some form of access to invoices. In the next section, we will discuss in more detail the access level for each user role. Edit settings. This access allows you to set up your organization in Xero. This includes, but is not limited to, the organization in financial, sales tax lookup, invoice settings, the ability to add and edit payment services, the ability to turn on inventory tracking. You can set up and update conversion balances with this access, and finally import and export a chart of accounts. This level of access is limited, as you can see, to the advisor and the standard roles here. View reports. This level of access allows the user to view, print, and customize reports. In the next section, we will discuss in more detail the access level for each user role. Publish reports. The only user that can publish reports, as you can see here, is the advisor. To publish a report simply means to take a snapshot of the report and save it so that it is no longer editable. This can be a great tool to use once you have completed closing your books. You can publish key financial statements like the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow statement so that if any changes are made, you can always go back to the published reports. The next tool, Lock Dates, is a great one to use so that you can be certain that no changes will be made once you have closed your books. Similar to published reports, only the advisor has access to lock dates. The lock date feature allows the user to stop anyone from making changes to transactions for a past period. For example, let's say that it's January 15, 2017. Acme Web Pros Plus is confident that all transactions for the previous year, 2016, have been entered into Xero. Acme has given their CPA an advisor user role so that she can log in and review the books and prepare the tax return. To ensure that no one on the Acme staff, except those with an advisor role, accidentally enters any transactions for 2016, the owner has set up a lock date to prevent this from happening. While the staff can enter transactions dated January 1st and after, they will be locked out from entering transactions dated December 31st, 2016 and prior, unless they have the advisor user role. Please note that you can also set lock dates that will stop all users, including advisors, from entering transactions. You can find more information on this by clicking the link below. There are a total of 6 user roles. 5 you can see here: none, read only, invoice only, standard, and advisor. And the 6th one is subscriber, which we'll talk about. So let's chat about the advisor role first. This user role has full access to Xero. As you can see, this includes but is not limited to the bank reconciliation, invoices, view reports, publish reports, and lock dates. This role is ideal for the business owner and an accountant who is responsible for all bookkeeping tasks. The standard role, one step below the advisor role, is very similar to the advisor role, with the exception that the standard user cannot lock periods or publish reports. This role is ideal for a tax professional that prepares your tax return and a bookkeeper who you don't want to give access to lock dates and publish reports. You can learn more about how the report settings work for this user by clicking the link below. Invoice only. This user level is limited to just someone who needs to create invoices and/or supplier bills with no access to bank accounts or reports. There are 4 levels of access for the invoice only role, starting with draft only. This user can add, copy, and save invoices, bills, quotes, and purchase orders. They can submit these documents for approval and make modifications as long as they have not been approved. After approval, they will be able to view any transactions that they have created. This role is great to give to someone who is brand new to your company or someone whose work you prefer to review and approve first before it goes out to a customer or supplier. Approve and pay. On top of being able to do everything that a draft-only user can do, the approve and pay user can also create repeating invoices, add tracked and untracked inventory items, approve invoices, bills, credit notes, quotes, and purchase orders, and view and pay bills created by other users. They can also record customer payments on invoices. This role can be given to someone who is more of a senior accountant or bookkeeper who you have enough confidence in that you do not need to review their work before it goes out to a customer or a supplier. Sales only. This user role has the same access as approve and pay, except that it is limited to just sales transactions only. This includes all quotes, invoices, and credit notes created by the user and other users. This user role is ideal for someone who is solely responsible for managing accounts receivable, like an AR clerk. Purchases only. This user role has the same access as approve and pay, except that it is limited to just purchase transactions only. This includes all purchase orders, bills, and credit notes created by the user and other users. This user role is ideal for someone who is solely responsible for managing accounts payable, like an AP clerk. The read-only role allows the user access to view most areas of Xero, but it does not allow them to edit any information. The read-only role is ideal for someone who does not need to enter or edit information in Xero, like a business partner who is not involved in the day-to-day business. None. Select this option if you are giving someone payroll admin permissions, which we will cover in detail later on. And finally, the role that is not shown here is subscriber. This role is automatically assigned to the person who set up your organization in Xero. By default, the subscriber is assigned the standard plus all reports access. So this role here. However, the subscriber can change his or her role to advisor if needed. The subscriber is the only user who can change the pricing plan, cancel your Xero subscription, stop a direct bank feed, and update the billing and payment information for your Xero account. Please note, if possible, this role should always be maintained by an owner or an officer of the company. Last but not least is the extra permissions section here. There are three additional permissions that can be added to a user role. The first one is manage users. This permission can be added to the standard or advisor roles. With this access, you can add a new user, change their permissions, or delete a user from Xero. Payroll admin. This role has access to manage all aspects of payroll, including employee details, running payroll, and reporting. You can add this permission to the standard or advisor roles. You can also give a non-standard or advisor role this access, provided they've been invited to your payroll as an employee. This would be ideal for someone who manages all aspects of payroll for your organization. And finally, contact bank account admin. This level of access allows the user to make changes to the bank account information that you have on file for a customer or supplier contact. We discussed how to enter this information for batch payments in the How to Set Up a Supplier lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. Once you've made your selections for your new user, you want to go ahead and click the Continue button. This is the message that the new user will receive. You can actually personalize it if you'd like to directly in this screen, or just use the default message that is shown. And once you are satisfied with the message, go ahead and click the Send Invite button. And our invitation has been successfully sent. Once an email invite has been sent to a new user, it will show a status of pending here. Once the invitation has been accepted, the status will change to active, as you can see here. Once you have set up users, you can add them at any time by repeating the steps that we walked through just a few minutes ago. You may also modify user permissions, delete a user who you no longer want to have access to your organization, and you can resend an invite to a user if they've never received it. So to edit or delete a user or resend an invitation, you simply want to just go ahead and click on the user's name. And in this screen, you can make any modifications that you need to the tasks that they have access to, or perhaps add additional permissions if needed. You can also delete the user here. This is ideal for someone maybe who you had to terminate or they no longer work for your organization. Once you've made the necessary changes, you want to make sure and just save them. And for those users who are still in a pending status, meaning they have not accepted their invitation, you can actually go ahead and resend the invite. So a couple things to note about this is the invitation must be accepted within 14 days. If it is not, then you absolutely will have to resend the invite to the new user. Make sure that you give them a heads up that you sent the invitation so that they can check their inbox and their spam folder to see if they received the email there. So to resend an invite, you simply click this button, Resend Invite. and it will be resent. One other thing I would note is double check the email address that you have on file to make sure that it is correct. That wraps up the lesson on how to invite multiple users to Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course, or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.